Najprej bi se zahvalila za to, ker smo vsi skupaj tukaj, filmskemu skladu in kino Dvor, da smo lahko izvedeli to tako neko multimedijalno zgodbo. Pogovor bi pa nekako odprla s tem, da je dokumentarni film, sploh kreativni dokumentarni film, na nek način kot neka poezija. In ta spoj med vama me zanima, pač kako se je začel in kako se je razvijal, kako se je cela zgodba brezmejnega začela med vama z Alešom.
The film started when Aleš was stipendiate in Berlin, and he told me a story that he wants to hike around Slovenia, and I was interested in that, seeing the borders.
Vse skupaj se začelo, ko je pač Aleš imel štipendijo v Berlinu in mi je nekako predstavil to zgodbo, kako si želi iti peš okoli sveta.
Yeah.
Slovenija.
Odlično bom prevajala, odlično bom prevajala.
Se, če si eno krok sveta bi tudi šel. Samo ne vem, če bi ostali toliko časa v kino.
Yeah, and then we decided to start a film about that. I accompanied him a little bit at the beginning, and then we decided then Jana decided to finance it. After that, we convinced her, and we Aleš made his hiking around Slovenia, and I was starting to the research in Slovenia.
Se pravi, Aleš je naredil pač ta pohod okoli Slovenije. Jana se je pridružila in nekako financirala to. Petra je pa ta ideja tako intrigirala, da pač posname ta film, ki ste ga danes videli.
So, and then it took some 2 or 3 years to get the finance done. And then we started to do the shooting at the beginning, 2010. I guess 2010 this shooting started.
2-3 leta smo celo stvar financirali in 2010 smo začeli snemati film. Ja.
Yeah, that's how they started.
Mm-hmm. But do you agree that this poetry and the road movie is kind of making sense?
Yes.
That's my additional question.
Yeah.
Če se strinja, da je poezija in ta popotovanje nekak ista zgodba, da to se skupijo. Zakaj si se odločil za to, za zgodbo Meja, oziroma zakaj ste se odločila za prav zgodbo Meja?
Why did you choose Borders? Because, I mean, I also did a film on Borders.
Yeah, because Slovenia is so small and there are only borders. So.
Ker je Slovenija tako mehna in so samo meje okoli. I like that answer. Všeč mi je to. Kaj pa ti? Isto vprašanje.
Zdaj, jaz sem se sam odpravil na to potovanje, ker sem hotel izkusiti, kako je to biti biti sam sabo, ker sem bil prepričan, da če nek človek hodi sam sabo na precej neturističnih poteh, da pride do nekih spoznanj, ne, globljih. Pa nič takega ni bilo. Nasprotno. Bolj je šlo za to, da so se mi neki brezvezni stavki ves čas pretakali po glavi levo in desno, ko sem hodil teh 34 dni okrog Slovenije. In 34, ja. In nisem prišel res do nobenega zaključka. Tudi noben tekst ni neposredno nastal, kasneje sem napisal en esej, tega je tudi on bral. Kar pa je bilo važno, je, da sem si v tem času prihodil nek čist drugi občutek za prostor. To pomeni, naenkrat sem pogledal nek hrib, pa sem vedel, aha, 4 dni hoda. In prihodil sem si nek drug občutek za prisotnost v času. težko razložiti, ampak enostavno bil sem na drugačen način zasidran v čas in na drugačen način tudi buden do tega časa. In to je bilo vse. Potem je Peter prišel s to idejo in jaz sem se kar nekaj časa kot kaka primadona upiral. To pa zato, ker iskreno povedano sem imel okrog sebe preveč prijateljev, ki so imeli izkušnje s filmom in vem, da so bile večinoma traumatične. In glede na to, da smo 8 let to skupaj pacali, vidite, da te travme so upravičene. In da bi moral poslušati ta svoj notranji glas. Takoj na začetku pa sem bil dovolj neum, da sem se vseeno spustil stvar. Spustil pa sem se zaradi Petra kot osebe. Sem prej gledal njegove odlične filme, recimo film o Malijo, o dunajskem džezisto, ali pa film Intermite, o scena, berlinska scena v začetku 90-ih. To so na nek način nekih internih krogih kultni filmi. In sem videl, na kak način funkcionira njegov um in da dopušča neke lege umetniškega izražanja, ki so danes na nek način izločene, povožene, da si upa dela tudi antifilme v dokumentarističnem smislu, anti-mainstreamovske filme.
We'll translate this.
Thank you.
Meni se pa zdi prav to fascinantno. Mislim, Peter, ti si pač Avstrijec iz Graca, seveda dolga leta živiš v Berlinu, oba dva žita v Berlinu in ima ta neko čist drugo zgodbo, distanco tega sveta, se pa vrneš nazaj na neko svojo mejo, ne, na svoj teritorij in ga pogledaš iz druge strani.
So born in Austria, then you return to your border and you see it from the other side.
Yeah. What was the question?
What's your
view to that?
Your view to that, yes. Yeah.
What changed? I mean, through Berlin, there changed a lot, of course, because Berlin, when I came to Berlin, was a city with a border, and you always had the feeling when you crossed the border. It changed then quite often, so I thought the chance is also in this film to see the vanishing borders, just to...
Ko sem prišel v Berlin, je seveda ta meja obstajala in seveda, da je vplivalo to na mene in pač moja neka ambicija, da vidim to spremembo meje.
The thing about borders was interesting for me also from my youth, you know. We Yugoslavia was a green border for me, but we couldn't change it that easily at that time. So we always had to wait as a child for all these borders. And when I saw the chance that the borders are open now, I thought that's maybe a topic for a film.
Zgodba iz moje mladosti tudi to, da sem dolg časa čakal, da se ta meja odpre, ne, iz druge strani, pač iz Avstrijske. In pač to je bila to neka šansa, da prodrem v film. Ne? Tako.
We made a film before in Slovakia and Czechoslovakia about gypsies, about Roma. And there when Slovakia was separated from Czech Republic, they built huge buildings, huge borders, and 2 years later they were empty because of the European Union. And I thought that's really interesting. What happens with this building, with this technical operations? What's happening with this?
Ja, podoben film sva posnela na češko-slovaški meji, kjer so z Romi in kjer so zgradili ogromne zgradbe v tem delu in me je zanimalo, kaj se ta sprememba, prav kaj se zgodi, ko se meja zbriše oziroma ko se premakne. V tem trenutku mogoče dam besedo vam, lahko se nam priključite, da ne bo to zdaj takole nekak zida med nami, tako da bi prosila, da se ta meja tudi tukaj le majčkan zbriše in bom zelo vesela vsakega vprašanja ali pa komentarja, namiga, odpiram možnost za
začutil to, kar je prej povedal, pa smo se vsi nasmejali, ampak je to res, da Slovenci verjetno glede na majhno število, glede na majhen prostor, ki ga zasedamo, smo resnično med narodi, ki smo najbolj prizadeti z mejami. Mislim, da je on to povedali, da vi ste nič velikega pravzaprav po tem doživeli. Mogoče bi tukaj, ker je film dokumentaren, le bi bilo dobro za film, čeprav je bil film všeč, ampak da bi več pregovorili tudi še domačini, recimo Videmska pokrajina cela manjka. Da bi videli, kako globoko je to vstop v Evropo in
She thinks it's some regions that are missing.
Hvala.
So the thing is that she's missing a Videm as well, the story of Videm, but the whole there's Udine. much more than what you have in film. Although she congratulates you on this.
Difficult to answer. I mean, of course, there are so many stories on borders. It could be a 10-hour film.
10 ur bi lahko naredil film o mejah, to je
And I didn't want to expand it too long, you know. It's I guess the film is quite right for me. I was shooting on other borders as well
and Tudi na drugih mejah smo snemali. Sam smo jih spustili.
That's of dramaturgical problems, you know.
Zaradi dramaturgije samega filma.
Mogoče bi jaz dodal eno stvar. Peter je večjih turah snemal in zmeraj znova je potem na grobo sam tudi delo šnit, ne, rezal. In mi je ta grob material pošiljal, jaz sem pa potem pisal tekste in vedno znova spreminjal, tako da so mi že šli popolnoma na živce. In vem, kako dramatično se je ta film dejansko večkrat spremenil. Se spomnim enkrat enega dokumentarnega filma obstaja o Picasso, kjer Picasso ima zelo kratek čas, da riše slika na steklo. In kamera je od spoda in potem Picasso ima 2 minute, 3 minute, on naslika, slika in se ti zdi, da je že to perfektna slika in potem, ne vem, 15 sekund pred koncem naredi 3 poteze in čist se obrne na glavo in podobno je bilo s Petrom, samo da ni imel 15 sekund, ampak 8 let. Zdaj pa si predstavljate, kako to gre. In zato se mi zdi tudi, je treba celo stvar imati kot neko učno uro slovenske obmejne zgodovine, ampak kot vzorčne primerke neke mejne problematike, ki ni zgolj nam lastna, ampak ki dejansko določuje evropski kontinent, polkontinent ali pa ta privesek Azije kot tak. In z tega vidika sploh postane ta zgodba zanimiva. Za tudi koga drugega, ne samo za nas, ki smo zdaj pač tukaj.
It's Europe in a nutshell, you know. You got everything around.
Evropa v lupini.
Yeah.
Vse imaš okoli.
Še
eno vprašanje je bilo tam, ja, takoj, ne.
Milan Novar, Varaždina prihajam. Čeprav govorim slovensko in pa dobro štajersko.
That's it.
Film se seli tudi v Varaždin, zato smo tudi z mojo drago ljubico tukaj. To ni tista, ki nastopa v pesmi. Ne vem, no. Ampak zdaj, če imam vprašanje, ki bi vedno že odgovoril, mene je zanimalo, malo tudi jaz nekaj poslušam pisati, ampak mene je zanimalo, kako so nastali teksti. In vedno že odgovoril, da so nastali, pa so bili vrženi strani, so se torej scene menjale, oziroma zanima me ta postopek, kako so ti teksti nastajali. In pa še eno vprašanje za ne za koga, kako so psi nastopili? Slučajno ali, ali ste jih prepričali?
How did the dogs enter the film? That's for you.
Have they been persuaded or by accident?
No, I fed them the whole night and waited on the other side.
Celo noč sem jih
hranil. It took me 2 days.
Dva dni mi sem rabo za te kadre.
No, it's documentary, you know. You're just there or not, you know.
Tam si ali pa nisi tam, to je to.
Tekst pa, mislim, ja sem res ogromno časa razmišljal o tem tekstu. In najprej sem pisal tekst brez slike, samo na neko temo. Od tega ni praktično nič ostalo, ampak je bilo na nek način neka štartna pozicija. Potem so se pojavljali deli, kjer sem se postavljal v to neko vlogo, seveda nekoga, ki piše. Ritmično se mi je zdelo zelo potrebno na nek način ta film, ki je zelo precizno, mnogoplastno strukturiran, vseeno mu dače en jezikovni ritem, ki se pač ustvarja s tekstom, tudi s temi ponovitvami, pisavmi in podobno. Potem pa se mi je zdelo predvsem važno, da tekst ohrani neko avtonomnost in deluje kot nek kontrapunkt temu, kar se kaže. In doskrat so neke pasaže, ki so že bile napisane, potem zelo lepo so upadle z nekim novim filmskim materialom. Tako da ga je trebalo samo še prisloniti na nek način, ne da bi ga pisal na to. Zdaj, ko gledam nazaj, vidim, da smo imela izjemno razkošje s Petrom, da smo lahko tok časa sedela za neko stvarjo. Nemci imajo to, ta pregovor gut ding braucht weile. To je bil ta, to meni čim, pač, da rabi dobra, uspešna stvar rabi velik časa.
No, it was really good to work with Aleš, you know, he immediately understood what these scenes, what the sense of this footage was, that out of that he easily could create little pieces, you know. And so it was a work in progress. Sometimes it didn't fit on the right position, then he shortened a little bit, but it wasn't that much that he had to rewrite it quite often. Yeah. Or did you rewrite it? No.
Pieces.
Yeah, parts. Yeah.
Mogoče bi še to povedal, ne? Seveda na začetku se ti zdi vznemirljivo, delaš film, ker smo imela res odlične pogovore ob tem in vse, kar to spremlja in dolgonočne pogovore in že zato se je splačalo. Ampak potem s časom leta minejo, meše so se zgodili dogodke, se ne vem, če je to sploh zdaj tu pravi okvir, ampak recimo Peter je imel koproducenta v Avstriji, ki je dobesedno ukradil material in potem je moral Peter procesirati, da ga je dobil nazaj. V bistvu, tu vidite en zelo nežen film, tako, ki se vi od zadej pa je bila čista kriminalka.
The next novel of Aleš.
Ja. Ampak seveda greš od te neke začetnega entuzijazma do nekih, ja, kako bi že, brez volja. Tudi skozi neko fazo sem šel jaz osebno, moram reči, Peter nikoli se mi zdi, ampak jaz osebno pa, da se mi je zdelo, pa kaj sploh snemamo v teh mejah, se tako zginjajo pa. Zakaj se bomo sploh šli, zdaj, mislim pa, ne, delamo nekega čisto pase filma tematsko in potem se nam zgodi to, kar se je žal zgodilo.
In bi si
danes res iskreno rečem, zelo želel, da bi bil to pase film, pa je kvečemo dobil nek nivo angažiranosti, aktualnosti, ki ga v bistvu nismo načrtovali.
It was not planned to be so kind of like up to date that it's happening again, that the borders are coming.
Yes,
up, you know?
Yeah. There was also a chance for the film, you know, just that we had this time window and that it ended at that time, you know. This.
Jana, I would like to bring you in a little bit with the choice of artists and the, you know, the whole production behind it, the support of all these 8 years and how the work between, you know, there's a lot, many of Slovenian talents which were involved even before I was involved as a co-producer. So I think this is
really beautiful. Rada bi pač vključila v tem trenutku Jano, ki je v osmih letih te produkcije nekako združila veliko slovenskih avtorjev, poleg tega pa pač, da nam mečkem poveza.
Zdržala
teh osem let. Ja. How did it all go for you?
Oh,
No.
I mean, it started in a way that I, at the beginning, when the idea came to make this film on these borders of Slovenia, I said, I'm out as a German producer. That was like my first...
Na začetku, ko se je začela zgodba o slovenskih mejah, je rekla, jaz sem, ne moram biti del tega kot nemški producent.
Because it's very, it's not easy to finance in Germany a topic without a reference to Germany.
Ja, zelo težko je financirati film, ki nima nobene reference direktne z Nemčijo.
And I mean, Peter is living in Berlin, but he actually he's Austrian. So this is one point.
Peter je živi v Berlinu, ampak je Avstrijec.
Then he wanted to shoot, I mean, it was clear that he wanted to shoot with Thomas Plenert, who is a quite famous German DOP, specialized on landscapes and traveling.
DOP Thomas Plenert je dost znan nemški cinematograf, ko se reče snemalc.
So it was clear that there are three points which was clear. There is Peter, the director, Aleš, the author, the co-author, and Tommy, which is are three points which is for Germany at the beginning not easy. So yeah. I said, okay, but then there was a festival, Berlinale, and we were going around with this idea and we met some Austrian film funds and they were very interested in the idea.
Na Berlinalu sem pač spoznala neke avstrijske financerje, ki so bili zelo zainteresirani, da bi to idejo med Nemcem, snemalcem, Slovencem in Avstrijcem združila.
Yeah, and suddenly we were invited to Ljubljana at a co-production meeting. So I was in as a producer.
Na koprodukcijskem sestanku v Ljubljani, ki je bil tle v Cankarjevem domu, sem prišla kot... Ja,
and it was my first time in Slovenia and I really liked it very much, so it was clear that I liked the project, I liked the atmosphere, I liked the topic, the people, so it was very clear that I will support the project as far as I can do it. Maybe I find an Austrian producer who can do it then.
Ja, upala sem, da bom našla avstrijskega producenta, ki bo to lahko speljo do konca, ampak zelo sem bila že na tem koprodukcijskem sestanku, mitingu, sem vedela, da bom ta film producirala.
Yeah. And then yeah, it continued, we went in the financing, we had to find an Austrian producer to get the Austrian funding, so we were like in this, and we continued the developing of the project, and it was very clear that we want to involve as much, I don't know, the creative people from Slovenia as much as possible. We wanted also to have somebody in the editing room who can speak Slovene. And it was clear that we want to edit in Berlin.
Yeah.
So we were looking who is there, and we came to Hanna Slak, director who lives in Berlin. So we had another creative.
Še en del je Hanna Slak, ki živi v Berlinu, ki seveda govori slovensko. In se pravi smo imeli še njo kot še... Še en velik del filma pač slovenske.
And the other thing was the musicians, because Peter was spending some time here and meeting some musicians, and it was also from the beginning very clear that he wants to work with
Nino
Digliaria, Brina
and Jelena.
Jelena. So it was clear, this was completely clear from the very beginning.
Od začetka je bilo jasno, da si želi delati z Nino, Jeleno in s Brino. Ja. Yeah.
So it started very well, it started very good, we came with a lot of energy into this film, it was shot very well, and then we had a break because we had an accident, so we had to stop for nearly 3 years completely.
Morali smo produkcijo staviti za 3 leta z tem primerom, mislim, s tem človekom, koproducentom iz Avstrije.
But it was only possible to continue because all of this energy, power and trust of the the creative people who were behind it. So that was the only way how it could really be finished.
Edini način je bil pač, da ste imeli ta support vseh teh kreativnih ljudi iz Slovenije.
And then we convinced Petra to help us.
Potem so pa mene prepričali.
Super, Petra.
Da se grem to. Vprašanje.
Jelena Gačeša, lahko bi bila iz Hrvaške, lahko bi bila iz Varaždina, ampak niso se mi Šiške. Naj me ne pohvalim film Golovno gospa. In verjemite, da kar kol bi rekla zopra film, bi bili to čisti politikanski razlog. Pa ta pokrajina manjka, pa te prizore preveč so predolgi, pa zakaj je idejno film tako čist, enoznačen, zakaj ni bilo skeptikov, ampak ne bom poprašala, da je film, ki na koncu pripravlja, ponuja to, da mora biti angažiran. Vemo, da bo nastopil tudi v garažah po vsej Sloveniji. Zdaj vas zanima, kako vidite pot v Evropo tega filma. Kaj je to, da razpada?
So her question is, how do you see the way to Europe of this film? Because it's kind of
falling apart.
Europe,
not the film.
Does the film go through Europe?
I mean, first we felt apart, then the film. No, it's a time window. You know, it's a documentary. It's a document of a special time, and we will look at it as a chance. We maybe missed, you know, but we don't know, you know, in 10 years it could be changing everything, you know. We even didn't expect this, you know. We thought the opening could go on, you know, and borders will vanish. Okay.
Time window?
Sorry, yes.
Yeah. I try to get something. Yeah. Se pač odpira, mislim, tega nismo pričakovali. Te stvari se nekak ciklično ponavljajo, ne, gre za neko časovno... časovni stroj, time window, I don't know how to translate.
Časovno okno smo ujeli.
Okno.
Yeah. Nek način, nek določen čas, ki pač govori zase in ki se nam danes zdi popolnoma utopičen. Mm-hmm. Danes se nam zdi popolnoma utopičen, pred tremi leti pa se nam je zdel popolnoma vsak dan in dolgočasen. In se moramo vprašati v bistvu o naši lastni percepciji in o naših lastnih pričakovanjih in zahtevah od skupne domovine Evrope. Tako moramo gledati. Ker če rečem domovina, po mojem bo 90% ljudi v tem prostoru pomislil na Slovenijo.
Ampak, da odgovorim na to potovanje po Evropi, film je že naredil nekaj držav. It's already been to some countries. It was in Macedonia, it was in Italy. It's going to Diagonale now after
Austria,
Germany as well. So, yeah, verjetno še vedno ljudi takšen film zanima. Yeah. I think it's still there's a lot of people interested in
this. Yeah, there's a lot of response to that, of course, because it's... Everybody's aware of that, what's happening, that Europe could get lost, but I guess we are more Europeans than those against Europe.
Evropa bi se lahko zgubila, ampak več nas je Evropejcev. Ja, sem to.
Yeah, we are more.
Yeah. Še kakšno vprašanje?
Yeah.
Tam od zade?
Morda.
Našemu pesniku, ki je ta film pomagal tako ustvarjati. Mi je to jaz prva zgleda nekoliko obupov, jaz ne stvarno da je čisto pesničko.
Hvala.
Dalje je rekel, da je tole, kar sem bil omenjeno, kot svoj film v izjavi sem tudi malo projekt v srcu, sem, kar sem bil, že da onaj karbon ne prečiteva, je to vaše.
Ja nisi nikjer prepisal. Da še to mislite? Ja, hvala.
Namreč, samo toliko sem iz Nove Gorice.
Aha.
Smo tretji najstarejši prebivalci, moji pokojni starši. In ko smo hodili v Italijo, smo pač morali imeti samo uno kilo in imeti lokalno. nekaj teh, bi rekel, da dobimo nazaj pohte.
Razumem.
In moram reči, da je to je bila ta pot naša. In to odlično razumem, kako ste to zajeli noter, to sintagmo tega prostora, tega odnosa med Italijo in takratno Jugoslavijo. Nekaj me tukaj zelo zanima, namreč moj prijatelj je tudi Iztok Mlakar.
His friend is Iztok Mlakar, a singer.
Yeah.
I'm prevajam, prevajam. Iztok Mlakar, a famous singer and poet. Kar povejte, kar povejte.
Ja, nekaj me tukaj zelo zanima, kot pesnika tudi, ne? Je od Verdinove Eneide čudovit vers, ki nam odgovarja v temu južnem prostoru. Slovenija je točno na sredi med južnim in severnim delom.
Virgil has a beautiful verse in...
To je Virgilov Mulcevan zefiri nato sine semine flores. To kar pomeni zvalovijo, južni vetrovi, nikad bi kdo temu primoral iz poezije iz srca.
The south winds were without any pressure.
Samo še tole, mi imamo burjo, pravimo na primorskem. Prihaja iz starogrške besede boreos, severni vetr.
We have bora, comes from boreos.
To je sem hotel še reči, da leta 1200, tako je Evropa takrat vzhodni in zahodni del razpada, 324 bitka pri Frigiju. Ne bom razlagal, ampak takrat je potem zadnji cesar Teodozij zmagal, tako že zadnji, ki še za par let združil imperij, potem je pa zelo razpadno. Pa Slovenija je zopet ta prostor za vredu. In znova Slovenijo imamo eno četrtino tega prostora, ki smo ga imeli pred stoletji. To, da smo se naselili v 6. stoletju, je na največji nesmisel zgodovinske, ne samo tukaj, v celotni Evropi, Aziji, kar v 20 letih samo ustanovi državo. Premaga najmočnejšo državo Zahoda, Frank. Kako je to mogoče, če so pa Grki, Arabi in preko Makedonci 200-250 let je prišel Aleksandra Makedonskega in da so naredili potem helenizem.
Ja, veste, v rokohitrskih zadevah smo pa Slovenci...
Eksperti.
Lahko skrivali tole pomest eno bolj banalno vprašanje, eno drugedno vprašanje. Mene zanima, kaj človek gleda na plot in me zanimajo neki globoki odgovori. Kaj je tisto, kar se vam je pojavilo banalnega, kar je skakalo levo in desno?
Mislim, banalnega. Zdaj, mi smo narod športnikov in tu sigurno so mnogi bistveno bolj poklicani, da dajo tu odgovore kot jaz. Jaz sem pač samo se malo sprehodil. Banalnega.
What's banal in the whole?
Sure. Povedali ste, da ste pričakovali neke globoke odgovore in se je v bistvu se vam neke take negloboke stvari.
Nekaj klokotanje besed v glavi, posameznih zlogov in tako, ki se kar ponavljajo. In v bistvu vidiš, da jezik imitira telo. Jezik imitira ritem hoje in na nek način se poskuša temu približevati. In kar od tega odnese še ta ritem. Ne toliko nekaj, kar bi bilo pomensko, kar bi bilo racionalno definirano, kar bi bilo zelo bistroumno to temu občinstvo podati, nič od tega, ampak res nekaj telesnega. So pa bili, mislim, po drugi strani mogoče tudi nekaj spomine, recimo jaz prihajam iz Slovenskih goric in zame kot otroka v 80-ih je bilo normalno, da smo šli recimo vsaki 14 dni v Avstrijo nakupovati in se vračati in potem seveda je bil tudi šmugl v tistem času nekaj popolnoma normalnega. In starša, predvsem oče nas je, on je se ukvarjal sitotiskom in je potem te drage barve kupoval, ki jih se ni dalo v Jugoslaviji dobiti in jih je seveda šmugla vprek, nikoli ni prijavilo in plačal carine in jih je seveda
pod otroka. No, in potem so, in so potem smo, s svojim sestru smo vedno tako nekako kot sediš malo na, in, in recimo še s tistega časa imam res vedno, vedno se mi malo zarosijo dlani, ko grem čez mejo. To so te recimo te banalne zadeve. So pa bili tudi recimo res neke neverjetne spomine. Prekrasno je bilo recimo hoditi po madžarski strani. Skozi gozdove in te popolnoma zapuščene vasi. In se spomnim, da sem enkrat prišel na dolino in je bila samo ena res taka propadla zidanca tam, taka cimprana hiša. In grem mimo, visoka trava, nišče ni kosil, zgledalo je popolnoma zapuščeno. In naenkrat se zasliši ženski glas, ki začne pet. Neka stara ženica, ki poje. In sem se tam ulegal v travo in je imela v bistvu zame koncert. In je bil Bela Bartok, mislim, neverjetno je bilo. In je bilo ene 3-4 ure čistega blisa. In bolj sem šel naprej. Ona ni vedela, da sem bil tam, jaz se nikoli nisem videl. Če se pogovarjamo o banalnih stvarih, to je banalno, če prav gre do metafizike.
Yeah, I mean, we're going to continue. I would also like to see your side of the border as a kid or as a kind of...
Yes, I got the same experience, also this nervosity and this...
I mean, it was really, really nice when we were talking about pumpkin oil, you know, yes. Which, you know, my mom comes from this region close to, yes. And so it's like, you know, we have one thing in common. Pumpkin oil is always like, yeah. I bring it over or he brings it over. So that's...
No, it's this childhood to cross borders was always an adventure, and it was always everybody was smuggling, so you always had a bad feeling.
Vsi smo švercali in to je bilo vedno povezano s slabimi nekimi vibe.
When we were in my youth to Berlin, you had these intershops there, and you had these really tough borders, and whatever you took with you, also Spiegel magazine or magazines, it was dangerous to take with you.
And they čez mejo v Berlinu je bilo zelo težko karkoli prinesti. Zelo, zelo močne so bile te, dosti bolj močne so bile te meje in še Spiegel revijo je bilo težko čez pripeljati.
So, and they controlled you for hours. I mean, it was really... You could stay there for 5 hours on the border and they controlled the car down and you had to tear off your clothes, so it was really terrible. Mm. And that's why I was so happy that these borders were vanishing, you know. Mm. We thought they'd never come back.
Pet urne kontrole so zginile, sem bil vesel, da so zginile, ampak sem upal, da ne bo nikoli prišle nazaj. But we're going on another trip, continuing. Zelo, zelo sem ponosna in srečna, da to ne bo pač klasična distribucija tega filma, ampak da gremo naprej v stilu, v kakršnem smo film začeli. Jutri gremo v Most na Soči, potem gremo v Novo Gorico, pa v Izolo in tako naprej, vse po mejah Slovenije in tudi
really
čez
great.
Meje in to je nekaj tako zelo specialnega in bi se rad zahvalila Niki in celi ekipi, ki smo v bistvu vse skupaj omogočali. No. Yeah. Tako da to je res nadaljevanje tega road tripa. Pa Simoni seveda in Alešo, ki bo tudi na teh projekcijah več ali manj z nami.
Jaz bi pa eno stvar še izpostavil, ki je bila omenjena, ampak mislim, da vseeno mogoče ne dovolj glasbo.
Ja.
Glasba je res... Yes. Glasba filmu je vse po mojem skromnem mnenju enkratna. Ne? Mm.
Ja, Nino Deglerja in Jelena sta kompozitorja glasbe, ki sta tukaj nekje.
Ja, no. Ampak se jih ne da prehvaliti. Tudi za vse...
In koncert danes.
Vse koncerte in vse, kar delate za film.
Yes, thank you. I forgot it, but it's really one important point in the music in this film. It was that really made the film, the atmosphere, and it was such a pleasure to work with them, to find the right sound, the right note to make this film work, you know. So it was a pleasure to work with them.
Ja, res je bilo zato, ni je bilo veselja z njima delati. Je pa tudi res, da, sta, da je to tudi eden od daljših procesov, ne?
Yeah, it's the same way we worked with the text, we also worked on the music.
Ja, isto, časa smo. Ja. He's talking about...
How did you find these people who, and how did you make them share their thoughts with you?
How did you find them?
Was it by accident or?
I mean, you can call it accident, but it's not. I mean, it's always like filming. It's always to be on the right point at the right time, you know. And to find them was, you can call it by chance, but we were there and talked to them, and then out of that, the situation. Developed that we could shoot later on. I mean,
dosti časa smo z njimi preživeli, lahko rečete, da je bilo to spontano in to pač, ampak ni bilo, ne. Velik časa, dokler smo potem začeli snemati in da se je celo skupaj.
I mean, maybe two examples. One is the customer in Ormož, in
Cariniku v Ormožu je en primer.
Vladimir Stelečić, and he was we found him on another border.
Našli smo ga na drugi meji.
And 2 years later, he was on this border where we shot.
Čez dve leti je bil na tej meji, kjer smo snimali.
And the other one is, I made a film 10 years before. I was shooting with the father of the owner of the pub in Contovello. And I wanted to visit the father. And then I realized that the son is half Slovene. And then I shot with him, so... This is just
iskal
two
sem
parts,
karakter, jaz, kjerim sem hotel snemati, potem sem pa njegovega sina.
Yeah. Others spoznal. Came through recommendation. We talked with Aleš, because of his trip around. Also with Petra
Aleš
in Zasic.
Aleš in Petra sta mi predlagala. Yeah.
So it's different.
Ja, jaz mislim, da bi bilo to tu. Ja?
Yeah. Some more questions?
Ja, se bi lahko še, ampak mislim, da smo rekli, da...
Jaz bi se zahvalil vsem vam, da ste prišli, to nas res po teh 8 letih napolnjuje z novo energijo in upamo, da se čez kakšnih 16 spet vidimo.